So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Speedboxing. Make sure you subscribe to my channel before you click onto any of my videos. Also, comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated. If you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So former two-time heavyweight champion of the world and the co-trainer of Shannon the Cannon Briggs, Chris Bird, says that in his opinion, Shannon Briggs is the best heavyweight in the world at the moment, and that he thinks Shannon Briggs will be able to beat somebody like Anthony Joshua. To quote Chris Bird here, he says that seeing him put in the work every day, seeing him getting hyped about the fight, this is what it's about. I'm going to tell you, and I'm being very honest, he's the best heavyweight in the world right now. I see these young guys, Anthony Joshua, I've seen Klitschko, we're watching the fight, and I'm like, he'll knock him out. He'll knock Anthony Joshua out, a young cat. He ain't even 30 years old. This man's 45 years old, still putting in that kind of work. Like I said, I know heavyweights. A man explosive, it's scary. Let's go, champ. And Chris Bird obviously has a lot of faith in Shannon Briggs. I think he's really surprised at the way Shannon Briggs, at 45 years old, is be able to train the way he has done. Got himself into excellent condition. Because after Shannon Briggs was absolutely battered by Vitali Klitschko in a fight a few years back, and he was put into hospital after that fight, he hit a really low point in his life. He ballooned up to nearly 400 pounds in weight, but then he managed to self-motivate himself and got himself back in the gym and started boxing again, and that's when he started the whole let's go champ thing. And a lot of people have got behind Shannon Briggs. They see him as a character, the way he confronts fighters like Vladimir Klitschko, David Haye, Deontay Wilder. Like, this guy is a very fun character in boxing, and he's fighting for the WBA regular title against Frezor Quendo on June the 3rd at the Hard Rock Hollywood in Florida. And I don't see Shannon Briggs, though, being very competitive with any top heavyweight in the world. Like, don't get me wrong, Shannon Briggs is still dangerous for maybe one or two rounds, three at most, because Shannon Briggs has always been that kind of fighter anyway. But especially now later on in his career, he starts off even faster because he hasn't got much in the tank, in my opinion. Like, Shannon Briggs can't go 12 rounds, like, at all. I think Shannon Briggs is spent after three or four rounds. And he hits very hard, Shannon Briggs. He's probably one of the hardest hitters ever in heavyweight history. He's knocked about 54 of his opponents out. But I just don't see him being very competitive against somebody like Anthony Joshua. And I don't think we'll ever see that fight. And I don't think we should see that fight. Because I don't really want to see Anthony Joshua beating up 45-year-old men like Shannon Briggs. We've seen Anthony Joshua do that enough when he fought guys like Michael Sprott and Matt Skelton early on in his career. And don't get me wrong, them fighters are not on the level of a Shannon Briggs even at this point. But it's still not nice to see. And even Vladimir Klitschko at 41 years old would still beat Shannon Briggs very convincingly, because we saw it in the Joshua Klitschko fight. Klitschko still looked fantastic and could still beat probably any top heavyweight contender in the world right now, Vladimir Klitschko. But good on Shannon Briggs for coming back. He's got this WBA regular title shot. And you know what? I'm hoping for Shannon Briggs to win that title. Let's go champ and all of that. Frezor Quendo, the guy he's fighting, has always been a nearly kind of fighter. Like, every time Frezor Quendo has ever stepped up, he's lost. He's lost to guys like John Ruiz and Chagayev and Evander Holyfield, guys like that. And yeah, good on Shannon Briggs for coming back and getting the shot at the heavyweight title, but I don't want to see him in there with any guys like Deontay Wilder or Anthony Joshua or even Vladimir Klitschko at this point. So comment below on what you guys think of Chris Bird's words here. I'm a poet and I don't even know it, but anyway, comment below. It's JM, it's Speedboxing.